was at the airport the other day. I'm sick and tired of flying. I tell you what, airport security pisses me off. They got, you read about that paper, them two little toddlers couldn't get on an airplane because their name matched somebody on the no-fly list? Good Lord, they're 1 year old. You know you can tell the difference between a terrorist and a toddler? On a terrorist, a diaper going to be on the head. All right, that's how you can tell. Unbelievable. They got absolutely nothing in common except for both diapers are full of crap. All right, that's what they got in common. I get so sick and tired of that political correct nonsense at the airport. Now here's what they want to do instead of doing the right thing. Here's they going to do. They're going to, oh, this might cost $300 million, but here's what they're going to do. It's some machine they're trying to develop that reads your mind when you go through it so they can actually see what you're thinking before you get on the plane. Yeah, that'll speed it up right there. I can see me at the airport, a long line of people behind me. What's going on? Oh, they got Larry the Cable Guy in the head reading machine over there. Right now, I guess he's got Heidi Klum bent over a truck bed, I guess. Right now. Yeah, I'd be the most popular head at the airport. But I do like traveling around. We usually take a tour bus when we go. I like seeing the country. And I love Pennsylvania. They good folks there. And they got a town there, though, called Intercourse, Pennsylvania. All right. Now, I'd been there once when I was a kid, and I got to tell you, it was kind of weird. I stepped in the wet spot when I got out of my car there. But my bus driver, we had to go to Intercourse. My bus driver, gay. All right. I'm like, whoa. We went ahead and went the back way. All right. That's what we did. Boy, that was a crappy trip. All right. I had to do it. Come on. I had to hit that one out of the park. But my wife got mad at me one time, said we went to Intercourse, Pennsylvania too fast. There was a fair there I worked, the York Fair, one of my favorite fairs. I love fairs. It's a lot of fun. I grew up, you grew up fairs? I got to tell you this, though, they ain't the most attractive people hanging out at fairs. They ought to call them unfairs, some of these places. I'm telling you what, and them rides. My buddy always wants me to go, hey, let's go on that Ferris wheel. I ain't going on no daggum Ferris wheel. You know, they put that up in an hour in the parking lot over there, all right? You ever try to put a stereo cabinet together in an hour? Eh, you got parts left over, all right? How safe is that, son, bitch? I went on a roller coaster one time, felt pretty good because the guy running it gave me two thumbs up, and then just as we left, I realized he only had two thumbs! Ah! And I hate the Midway games. Good Lord. Have you ever... Tell me they don't get more difficult every year, Midway games. It's easier taking a picture of your butthole with a camera phone than winning a dadgum teddy bear. It is. Them Midway games. Well, what do you do? Oh, it's easy. All you got to do is knock off them three stack cinder blocks for that baseball made out of feathers. It's really easy, all right? It's cheap, too. Three balls for $60. Give it a shot there. Yeah, that's why they call it a Midway. You go broke Midway, too, to some bit. I broke a Pepsi bottle at this one joint with a baseball. I go, how many more I got to bust to win a prize? He said, you dumbass, you're at the concession stand. Went to Hooters when I was down there. I like Hooters. Y'all like the Hooters? I tell you what, I don't know if I'm going to eat there no more. I'm going to tell you, if them shorts get any shorter on them girls, the FDA's going to start making them wear hair nets. Man. Good Lord, that's unsanitary right there. My chicken wings needed a comb over. I know, it's ridiculous. I'm walking out, you're like, how was everything? Everything's pretty. Get her done. You know what I did find out, though? This made me happier than the Pillsbury queer boy frosting up some hot butt cakes, I tell you. Hooters got an airline now. They fly into Atlanta, Georgia. Good Lord, that's a good airline. I got 8,000 frequent boner miles on there, all right. Yeah, that's a good airline. First time I ever asked for an aisle seat and prayed for turbulence on an airplane. But them flight waitresses, they ain't very smart, though. They had the Hooters flight attendant in there, and I asked her if I could see the cockpit, and she pulled her shorts down. You believe that? I'm with you. It was ridiculous. And the idiot next to me goes, "Is that the black box they always talking about right there?" Reverend, do you want to knock it off? Don't give the preacher nothing to drink no more. But they was pretty girls on there. There's some airlines ain't got pretty girls. I was on this airline the other day. I ain't gonna mention the name of them, Continental. All right, but they was the ugliest flight attendants I ever seen. I shouldn't have made eye contact, and I did, and I looked right at that one girl, and my wiener went in and out my butt crack. All right? I swear. My eyeball seen her, my wiener come out, spun around, shot right out my damn ass crack. And that's documented. That's a true story right there. You know you're ugly when you're making fellas poop their own wiener. You know what I mean? That's glamour shots ugly right there. That's glamour shots ugly. I don't like going to the airport no how because of the daggone security. Don't profile nobody, which pisses me off. I mean, it's irritating. You got to take everything off. Take your jacket off. Take your shoes off. I went through the other day to save time and nothing but a pair of Speedos. And they still pulled me out and accused me of smuggling in a pocket knife. Make you take your shoes off now because of the shoe bomber. Take your shoes off. They need to start making women take their panties off. Then I'll go back to the airport. Shoot, I'll get there early for that flight. Sorry, ma'am, you're going to have to take your panties off. It's a law. Take them off. What the hell? Is that a fuse? Hey, security, we got a panty bomber over here. Security, we got a panty bomber. That ain't right. Lord, I apologize for that. Even though it was funny. And be with the starving pygmies in New Guinea. Amen. My grandma almost got in trouble at the airport. She had some marijuana in her purse. Because she's on the medical marijuana for her eyes. I don't think it's making her see any better, but she is making some really good brownies. I tell you that, but... Good Lord, I bet they're getting $200 a plate for them up at the church. They always say, you take marijuana, make you see better. Let me tell you something. You want to see better? Drink tequila. You drink that, you're going to see stuff you ain't never seen in your whole life on tequila. But that's a bad deal. I don't drink no more tequila. I used to drink tequila, but my neighbors got up a petition, so I can't do it no more. And I don't care what they say, I still say it, none of them puppies look nothing like me. All right. I don't want to talk about that, all right? But it was a long night, that's all I know.